Hello, and welcome to today's episode of Direct Flight, the visual podcast. My name is Dessa. This is my compatriot and co-pilot for the day, Paper Tiger. The rules are, as ever, unchanging. Each of us chooses a beverage. When the beverage is done, the interview's over. My guy, Paper Tiger, is the designated driver today, so instead of choosing a sickeningly sweet beverage in an airplane-sized bottle serving, he'll be drinking simply some maple syrup from a dessert glass. Direct flight.
What'd you choose?
Kinky liqueur.
Kind of goes with the syrup, I think.
Okay.
Like a beer.
A brief conversation about crafting process with my Paper Tiger.
Okay.
How long is the longest acceptable length of a pop song?
3 minutes, 22 seconds.
Chacon was like 5 minutes.
What's that pop song?
What beat are you absolutely proudest of career-wise?
Lola.
What beat are you proudest of on my record?
Warsaw.
How long have you been making these?
Since 2002.
Is there an instrument that you absolutely won't use in a beat because you hate the sound of it?
Saxophone.
Have you ever heard a piano play forwards?
Yeah, I don't like it.
You don't like it, okay.
It's just not the same to me.
I'm done with this switch.
Oh, okay. Nice syrup. Alright. What was the first song you finished?
It was a song that was based off of a lullaby that my family sang. It was called Anino Nando, and I wrote it in Spanish.
Do you have to be in love to write a love song, and do you have to be sad to write a sad song?
Yeah.
Where does the title Warsaw come from?
There's that section like right before the instrumental break, where I was like, I've done some living in a glass house,
right.
High notes with a mother off the walls off.
Sure.
Everybody thought walls off, sounded the same.
Cool.
And I had just been to Warsaw this year, and I thought it was a pretty like tough-ass place to name a song.
I like it. What's with all the cursing?
I think I curse on 3 songs. I think I curse less than anyone you work with.
True.
Okay.
When do you know a song is finished?
Shit, that was one that I...
Again with the cursing?
Okay, sorry. When do I know a song is finished? I think a lot of times I'm working like in little pieces like this. You're not looking. It's a visual thing. And then it's like there are gaps between the finished pieces. And so it almost feels like you know when you make a quilt?
Sure.
Yeah. You've got all the pieces, the big pieces done, and then you just have to seam them up. How do you know when an interview's done?
When I get this question answered, why do you have pretty big bowl of cut up bananas in the freezer? That's more than one banana, right?
That's 3 bananas, man.
Okay, why?
Okay, well, I was going on tour. It was 2 weeks ago, okay? I was leaving for South by Southwest. And that means that essentially I have to burn my entire house down every time I go. You know what I'm saying? Because I have to stop the mail from coming. I have to take out anything that could rot.
Wow.
We're in the middle of an interview.
I know, I've just realized what happened though. Is that you wouldn't throw a banana away.
So I peeled the motherfucker and I cut it into lots of little pieces and I threw it in the fridge.
They look delicious.
Direct flight.
Interview's over.
You better take all that maple syrup down.
A whip with no candle, a wheel with no axle, a ride with no saddle, no leash, then I'm dragging the kite. A blade with no handle, a brick for your window, a bomb, but I'm single and dumb, and I'm the same on both sides.